What's up everyone, I am back with another mask review. In this video we are going to be taking a closer look at the Jacob Atkins mask. Jacob Atkins is a character in Josh Hastie's Candy Corn. That is a 2019 movie for those of you that don't know. Jacob Atkins is portrayed by Nate Chaney. Nate Chaney did an excellent job portraying this character. He just brought very creepy vibes to the movie and the character itself. So with that being said, let's take a closer look at this mask. This mask is from Trick or Treat Studios, and it is sculpted by Justin Mabry. I got this mask at Halloween City for about $60. And honestly, I'm very pleased with this copy. Because it doesn't happen often when you get a mask from Trick or Treat Studios that it comes with great detailing and a great paint job. Sometimes the details are washed out by an overusage of paint, or sometimes your details pop and there's just not a good paint job on the mask. But for this mask in particular, they knocked it out of the ballpark. It's definitely a home run with this mask, at least this copy. I'm sure there's copies out there that are not going to be as great, but the accuracy is it's up there with this mask. The paint and the details just stand out and they look amazing. Let's check out this blood application. I love how simple they were with it. They didn't overuse it. Usually when you oversaturate a mask with blood, it kind of just looks like a mess and it doesn't look as intimidating. It just looks like one giant mess. And I do not like when blood is overused on a mask because it takes away the presentation of the details. I do love the look of this mask. It has like a skull vibe with a pumpkin vibe, and they're kind of mashed up and rotting as one. I found that to be very interesting and different. Let's take a look at this other side. Got some blood up on the forehead here. It seeps down past the eye and down to the mouth and lower jaw. I feel like this is the more brutal side of the mask. I love me some good old brutality on a mask. My only complaint about this mask is the hairline and the hair. The hairline, because they just did one slap of glue and they kind of just attached all the hair to that one slap of glue that they applied. So what I went and done, I did another layer of glue underneath all the hair. So that layer of glue lies behind the hairline, and I kind of pressed all the hair down. And the hair hasn't slipped out since, because previously, before I did that second layer of glue, I was having thick strands of hair come out, and it was not cool, so I went in, added some glue, and the hair stayed intact, which is nice. I kind of do wish the hair was a little bit more ruffled up like it was in the movie, but, you know, you can't expect much from Tots when they do these hair jobs, because their main focus is just trying to get these masks out. I know they can do it, but they choose not to for some reason, but for a mass-produced mask, you know, we can't complain, especially for $60. I'm actually really happy I got this mask because it was a mask that was on my wish list for a long time. And it's finally a mask that I can scratch off the wish list. So yeah, definitely happy I got this one. I'm also a really big fan of the film. So yes, finding this mask was awesome, and it was a mission accomplished on my end. I never noticed this mask at any other stores. So I'm not sure if they just had a lot and they decided to send them out this year, because I didn't notice any at any stores last year. But this year I noticed Halloween City had a few copies for $60, so I ended up getting one, and that was the end of that. I'm glad I did. This mask is my new favorite within my collection. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, drop a comment, let me know what you think of the mask and the movie, and if you haven't subscribed, please be sure to smash that subscribe button and smash that bell button. As always, stay spooky and thanks for watching.